Hello students, from this lecture we are going to start chapter 7, structural organization in animals. Now as you know very well, animals, they may be unicellular or multicellular type of animals. In unicellular type of animal, only one type is cell is there which perform various function, but in higher organism, multicellular organisms, tissues are present and they perform various functions. In multicellular organism, a group of similar cells along with intercellular substances, they perform a specific function and it is known as tissue. In previous chapter also, you have already studied about plant tissue. Now we are going to study about animal tissues. The structure of the cells vary according to their function, and that's why these tissues are classified into four categories. So animal tissue, four types are there: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue and neural tissue. First, epithelial tissue. As the name suggests, it's actually outer covering, outermost epithelial tissue. It provides covering or lining for some part of the body. Here, cells are compactly packed without any intercellular spaces. So these are main feature of epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue further classified into two types: simple epithelium and compound epithelium. Simple epithelium is composed of single layer of cells and functions as a lining for body cavities. Compound epithelium, it consists of two or more cell layers and has protective function as it does in our skin. Simple epithelium further classified into squamous epithelium, cuboidal epithelium and columnar epithelium. So this way, epithelium tissue main two types, simple and compound, and simple epithelium further classified into squamous, cuboidal and columnar epithelium. Simple epithelium. This tissue is composed of single layer of cells and its main function is it acts as a lining of body cavities, ducts and tubes. So this way, it is composed of only single layer, so it's a one type of simple epithelium tissue. Compound epithelium tissue, as you know very well, it consists of two or more than two layers of cells and it has protective function. Simple epithelium tissue is further classified into squamous, cuboidal, columnar epithelial tissue. First, squamous type of epithelium tissue. Here, it is made up of single layer of flattened cells with irregular boundaries. So, this is main feature of structure of squamous type of epithelial tissue. Generally, this type of tissue is present in lining of blood vessels and air sacs of lungs. Second type, that is cuboidal epithelium. This tissue is made up of single layer cube-like cells and it is found in ducts of glands and tubular part of nephron of kidney for absorption and secretion. So we can say here, if we compare between squamous and cuboidal type of epithelium tissue, generally the cell shape of squamous type of epithelium is near to square shape, but in cuboidal type of epithelium tissue it is cube shape. Both they are present in different location in body. Columnar epithelium. This tissue is made up of tall and slender cells. In this tissue, nuclei are located at the base region. Free surface may have microvilli found in lining of stomach and intestine. Ciliated one, they are called as a ciliated epithelium. So this way, in columnar type of tissue of epithelium, it is composed of single layer of tall and slender cell. The free surface may have microvilli and it provide lining of stomach and intestine, and its main function is secretion and absorption. Columnar and cuboidal type of epithelium tissue is a specialized for secretion, so known as glandular epithelium, and it may be unicellular as in goblet cell of our alimentary canal, or may be multicellular as in salivary gland. So when we discuss about columnar and cuboidal type of epithelium tissue, it have this type of specialization of cell. So main function is a secretion, and it's a basically known as glandular epithelium. So some columnar or cuboidal cells, they get specialized for secretion and they are called as a glandular epithelium. There are mainly two types: unicellular, consisting of isolated glandular cell or goblet cell in alimentary canal, or maybe multicellular, so one type of cluster of cells in salivary gland. So on the basis of their mode of pouring their secretion, the glands is divided into main two categories. It may be endocrine gland or exocrine gland. Endocrine gland, it secretes the enzymes, milk, mucus, saliva. Exocrine, that's a endocrine gland, it secretes hormones. Its product is released through duct, and its product is directly released at targeted site. So the secretion of endocrine gland, that is hormone. The secretion of exocrine gland, it is generally known as enzyme. Compound epithelium. This epithelium is different than simple epithelium. Here, compound epithelium, it is made up of more than one layer. It means that multi-layer cell type of structure, and it is having limited role in secretion and absorption. The main function of compound epithelium tissue is to provide protection against chemical and mechanical stress. A compound epithelium, it covers the dry surface of skin, moist surface of buccal cavity, and at some other region like pharynx, inner lining of ducts of salivary glands, and pancreatic duct also. Epithelial cells are held together by intercellular material to form specialized junction in multicellular organism also. Now let's discuss about this type of epithelial junction. Here, this type of junction, so all cells in epithelium are held together with little intercellular material. It nearly all animal tissue specialized junction provide both structural and functional links between its individual cells. Namely, three types of cell junctions are found in the epithelium and other tissues. They are called as a tight junction, adhering junction, and third type is gap junction. Tight junctions, they help to stop substances, keep neighboring cell together. So it's a one type of help to stop leaking. Adhering junctions, It perform cementing to keep neighboring cell together. So its main role function is cementing. Third type, that is gap junctions. It facilitate the cell to communicate with each other by connecting the cytoplasm of adjoining cell for rapid transfer of ions, small molecules and sometimes big molecules also. So this way in epithelium three types of junctions are there. It is tight junction, help to stop leaking. Second, adhering junction to perform cementing in neighboring cell. And third is gap junction, which facilitated the cell to communicate. In this figure, you can study this type of intercellular junction. As we have talked, tight junctions, desmosomes, gap junctions. So, diagram also it specifies tight junction as well as gap junction here. So, as per theory of tight junction, this help to stop leaking, then adhering type of junction, and gap junction is one type of tubular channel between cell, and its location is also different in animal body. So this way its epithelium junctions are arranged in body. Second type of tissue, that is connective tissue. As the name suggests, it connects something. It is actually most abundant and widely distributed tissue which link and support the other tissue. And due to this special feature of this tissue, it is known as connective tissue. All type of connective tissue except blood cells, they secrete fibers of structural protein. Generally, they are known as collagen or elastin. Their nature is protein nature to provide elasticity and flexibility where they are present. So, these are special features of connective tissue. First type of connective tissue, that is loose connective tissue. As per term suggests here, they contain cells and fibers which are loosely arranged in semi-fluid ground substance, and that's why it is known as loose connective tissue. This tissue includes two type of tissue. It is areolar tissue and adipose tissue. Now let's compare both type of loose connective tissue, that is areolar connective tissue and adipose type of connective tissue. Areolar connective tissue, which contain fibroblast, macrophages and mast cell in its composition. In adipose tissue, its composition, it possesses fibroblast like areolar tissue, no, it's not present, as well as macrophages and mast cells, they are also absent. So it's a different between this type of tissue, areolar, which contain fibroblast, macrophages and mast cell, which are absent in adipose type of tissue. Second, areolar tissue, it acts as support framework for epithelium. In adipose tissue, cells are specialized to store fats beneath the skin. So, structure wise also they are different, as well as function wise also areolar and adipose tissue both are tissue different. These both types, areolar and adipose, they are type of loose connective tissue. dense connective tissue. This dense connective tissue, it contains mainly fibers and fibroblasts, which are compactly packed or compactly arranged, and that's why it is known as dense connective tissue. Orientation of this fiber may be regular or sometimes also they show irregular pattern. In dense regular connective tissue, collagen fibers are present in rows between parallel bundles of fiber, as in tendon and ligaments. So this way, in dense regular connective tissue, a fiber of collagen, they are present this way, the form of bundle fiber in tendon and ligament. Difference between tendon and ligament. Tendon connects bones to skeletal muscle, but ligament, it connects one bone to another bone. So in connection, it's a difference between tendon and ligament. Tendon connects bones to skeletal muscle, but ligament, it connects one bone to another bone. Second point of comparison, that is, tendon is made up of white fibrous tough tissue. Ligament, it is made up of yellow elastic tissue with collagen fibers. So these are main differences between tendon and ligament. Some other type of connective tissue, as they are specialized tissue, cartilage, bones and lung, they are also known as connective tissue. Let's compare cartilage and bone. Cartilage is soft skeletal tissue, but bone, it is hard skeletal tissue. In cartilage, chondrocytes are enclosed in small cavity with matrix. In composition of bone, it is rich in calcium salt and collagen fibers. Cartilage, generally, they are present in tips of nose, outer ear, between vertebral bones. Bone, they form the skeletal framework of vertebrate like limbs, leg and some other parts. So, this way, the difference between cartilage and bone. Main difference, cartilage is soft type of skeletal tissue, bone is hard type of skeletal tissue. There is a difference in between these two. In composition also, in cartilage, chondrocytes are enclosed in small cavity with matrix, while bone is rich in calcium salt and collagen fibers. Cartilage, they are present in tips of nose, outer ear and in between vertebral bones. Bone is actually composed the skeletal framework of body in vertebrate, especially in limbs, legs and some other part. Blood. Blood is also fluid connective tissue. It contains blood plasma, red blood cell, white blood cell and platelets. In figure also you can see this component of blood. So its nature is fluid type of nature, and it connects various organ of the body, and that's why it is known as fluid connective tissue. Main function of blood in body, it helps in transportation of various substances between organs. So this is a specialized function of blood in higher organisms. In this figure you can see this component of blood, RBC, that is red blood cell, red in color and shape is biconcave shape. WBC, that is white blood cell, it's a colorless. Platelets, they are also present in composition of blood. muscle tissue. As you know, in our body, this type of muscles are there. It is made up of some other type of muscle. So many types of muscles are there. Each muscle is made up of long cylindrical fibers arranged parallel to each other. These fibers are actually, they are composed of fine fibrils, and this unit is known as myofibrils. So we can say this way, each muscle is made up of muscle fiber, and muscle fiber is composed of further fine fibrils known as myofibril. Muscle fiber contract and relax in response to stimulation. So main function is contraction and relaxation in the body. Mainly, this muscle tissue is responsible for movement of the body. These muscles are of three types: skeletal muscle, smooth muscles, and cardiac muscle. This figure we can study and compare all three type of muscle. A figure is about skeletal muscle. It is also known as striated muscles. In this muscle, you can see this muscle fiber is possess striation, and that's why it is also known as striated type of muscle. Second type of muscle, in B figure, you can see these are smooth muscle tissues. Here is full mother muscle fiber and nucleus, you can see. Third figure, it is about cardiac muscle tissue, the specialized tissue. They show also striation, nucleus is present, and junction between adjacent cell. So this way, three type of muscles, skeletal, smooth, and cardiac type of muscles are there. Now let's compare all three type of muscles, skeletal, smooth, and cardiac type of muscle. Skeletal muscle, they are striated and voluntary muscle. Smooth muscle, they are unstriated, it means lining spans are not observed, involuntary type of muscle. Cardiac muscles, they are specialized muscle, specially present in heart, that's why heart muscles, and involuntary in nature. Voluntary means it under our willful control, as per our wish we can move, but involuntary, it is not under control of our will, we can't control its movement. Skeletal muscle, they are multinucleated with light and dark bands, that's also known as striated muscles. Smooth muscles, they are uninucleated without any bands, that's why also known as unstriated muscle. Cardiac muscles, they are uninucleated with faint light and dark bands. Skeletal muscles, they attach with bones. Smooth muscles, they are present in vessels, esophagus. Cardiac muscles, they are present only in wall of heart. Skeletal muscles, they are fibrous and unbranched, cylindrical in shape. Smooth muscle, they are fibrous and unbranched and spindle shape. Cardiac muscles, it is fibrous and branched, cylindrical in shape. So this way, all three type of muscles, skeletal, smooth muscle, cardiac muscles, they are different in their structure or composition, as well as their location, presence in body is also different. Other type of tissue, that is neural tissue. It's actually unit of our nerve system, and it is known as neuron, or we can also say nerve cell. Neural tissue, it exerts the greatest control over the body's responsiveness to changing conditions. Here, neurons, they are a unit of neural system and they are excitable cells. Neurological cell, it protects and supports the neuron. When this neuron is get stimulated, electric impulses are generated and they travel along the plasma membrane. This figure gives clear idea about composition of neural tissue. Here fibers and like axon and dendrites are present. So two type of fibers are there, axon and dendrite. Main part, that is cell body, which possess nucleus in its composition. So the structural and functional unit of this neural tissue, nerve tissue, that is neuron or nerve cell, and so also specialized tissue, and it is having greatest control over the body activity.